volunteered individually for sailing on board Madhi. When Navy asked for volunteers to take part in a Cape Town to Rio de Janeiro race, which happens every 3 years, so Navy wanted volunteers to take part in that race, and volunteers specifically from the women officers of the Navy. So for that particular expedition, myself and Lieutenant Swati had volunteered, and out of about 10 lady officers of the Navy, two of us were selected for that particular race. It happened in 2014. Before that, we had been taking part in, you know, small sailing championships which keep happening in India, you know, in the boat pools there, and the Indian Navy keeps organizing such sort of championships. So apart from that, we did not have any idea of as to how an ocean sailing passage would be, because otherwise in the Indian Navy, the women officers do not go on combat platforms and warships to sail. So we had absolutely no idea about you know, how an open ocean passage is all about. And we sailed on board Madhi with Commander Dilip Donde as skipper, who is also the first Indian solo circumnavigator of the globe. He has sailed on Madhi and he has seen the boat from scratch since the boat was built in Goa. So he knows in and out of the boat, and he is the only person who could have been you know, a guiding source for us to have you know, embarked on such an expedition. So he has been our mentor, and since 2014 we have been training under him. Now, since we had not sailed together as a team, we had to be given that exposure to sail as a team. That's how this idea came to make us sail to Mauritius. Before this, five of us had sailed from Vizag to Goa with stopovers, of course. The passage was about 2600 nautical miles. If you see a straight line distance from Goa to Mauritius, it will be about 2500 nautical miles. But we took a passage, we took, I will not say a detour, but since it's a sailboat, it is run on winds. It cannot run on motor that you just, you know, put up an autopilot and set a course and then you, you know, sail straight from Goa to Mauritius. It doesn't happen that way on a sailboat. It is dependent upon winds. So as with the prevailing conditions of winds, we took a, you know, route which came down south, crossed the equator, and then we headed west, covering about, if you say, we would have covered about 3,000 nautical miles or so. And most of the voyage was, we saw a lot of rough patches, which otherwise in our previous voyages we had not much experienced, had not had such an experience before, of you know, having to see a lot of squalls and a lot of rain, because the southwesterly monsoons in the northern hemisphere had just about set in. So there was you know, a lot of rain and lot of squally activities and you know, lot of frontal systems forming up. So this was the first time that we had experienced such sort of a weather you know, phenomena. And it was great that we got through it safely, and we landed here after 20 days of the voyage. Otherwise, more or less, the voyage was extremely blissful, and it was great to have all of us together to have sailed in such conditions and you know, arrived in Mauritius safely. And it was very, very heartwarming to see that you know, when we were welcomed so nicely by the High Commission, who took a lot of pain to keep track of the entire voyage, and you know, have received us so nicely. We got a lot of officers and constables from the Mauritian Coast Guard to embark on our boat, and it was really very you know, very heartwarming to see that sort of welcome that we had never ever experienced before. It's a very, very modern boat with state-of-the-art equipment inside. You will not find any equipment which is not matching with the present-day you know, equipment which are fitted on board warships and other sailboats of you know, similar class. So it's got everything. If you see from a navigation point of view, We have all the state-of-the-art navigation equipment, and also the other equipment which are fitted on board are absolutely state-of-the-art. It's not something you know which is belonging to an olden era or something like that. It's not like that. It's just a sailboat. And sail ships have been sailing since times immemorial. It was, you know, even before induction of warships and other ships, it was the sail ships, you know, which started going venturing out in the sea. So that way, yes, we are following a mode of sailing which has been since, long eons back. But otherwise, all the equipment inside are absolutely state of the art.
Being a group, I won't say it is tough because almost all of us know what needs to be done at a particular point if it is an emergency. Even if the person doesn't know, he'll go to the other person. Like at any given point of time, there should be two people on the watch checking everything on board because the winds are before a squall, everything is calm. So if you think everything is calm and you put up all the sails up, and within no fraction of time, like in 1 or 2 minutes, the gusty wind will rise up to like 35-40 knots. So in that case, one person handling the boat is really difficult. So we all, 6 of us, will gel together. Like the person who's on the watch will go to the other person and tell that person that this is going to happen. I think we should take a call. Of course, everything will be done according to the skipper. Like if I have to do something, I'll ask the skipper that this is what I'm thinking. Apart from that, it is tough. Of course it is tough. It's not very easy. It's not at all easy. For people, those who go outside like 2 hours, 3 hours, they get seasick. But to get used to the sea, because our endeavor to come at this point of time, see if we come in summers or if we come in any other part of the year, it will be easy for us. But choosing this particular period is like we are going to sail for the circumnavigation, which will be next year, 2017, that will be post-monsoon. But if you see Southern Ocean, the southern peninsula of the earth is only the water. There is no landmass in between. So the wind is continuously blowing and it's according to the systems, it's keep raising. There is no landmass in between to break the wind. So the sea is going to be very rough, very, very rough. Just to have a feel of that, we choose this particular part of the year to sail from India to Mauritius because we experience at least a bit of what southern oceans are going to be. So we actually choose this tough period to sail because we'll have that experience. To prepare for the eventualities, yes, we need a lot of experience. And the circumnavigation is going to be next year. The dates have not yet been decided. It will be decided by the Navy post-monsoon. That will be in 2017. Which will take about 8 to 9 months to complete the entire voyage, and there are some particular rules to complete. So the green signal will be given by the Navy that yes, of course, the skipper and the crew should be ready, that yes, at this time, because if you continue doing the training, yes, there will be a training continuous for 2 years, 3 years. It is you who will decide that yes, I'm ready for this. So like now, when we were ready for this, yes, we were ready actually. If we wouldn't have been ready, we wouldn't have made this voyage.